Greetings, beer thinkers. I'm having what I think is one of the very few IPAs from Single Cut that I have not had. I've drank a lot of their IPAs, and some I really liked, and some I thought, nah, this is just like drinking soapy water. This one is called Is This the Real Life IPA? Definitely a reference to that kid who was high on medication after some kind of surgery. I don't know if you've seen the video, probably. And it is an original combination of Pacific Northwest and New Zealand hops, totaling 122 IBUs, and they always seem to say their IBUs are so high, but over when it gets over 100, it kind of means nothing. And I've only noticed a couple of their beers to be too bitter. I looked up this beer a little bit more online, and I read that they hop it with Kohatu, which is a New Zealand hop that has the classic tropical fruit thing, but isn't quite as resinous and in your face. And then, I guess after they hop it with that New Zealand hop, they dry hop it three times with Pacific Northwest hops. So I'm not sure how the Kohatu is going to have much of an effect. Maybe it'll have a more subtle bitterness or something, since they dry hop it with just the Pacific Northwest hops. But that info I wasn't getting directly from the brewery, so maybe this isn't exactly that beer, but it is in some way American hops and New Zealand hops. It was bottled 8 days ago. This bottle says 720, and I already got a whiff of some fruity, kind of citrusy hops right when I opened the bottle. Now, Kohatu is a New Zealand hop descended from Hallertau Middelfrö. That looks great. Oh yeah. And Hallertau Middelfrö is a classic German hop, but wow. I feel like I'm getting a lot of New Zealand things out of this. The classic sort of lime that I notice, almost green pepper. There's lots of lime coming out of this, but it's not like a lime, like, pith and pithy citrus bitterness. It's juicy lime with a little bit of mango in there. Not much weird resinous green things happening. I'm not getting onion or any of that. Maybe just a touch of pineapple. But mango and almost a banana flavor, like aroma. Maybe sort of apricot-y. Definitely orange. Lots of sort of, not lemon, but more like sweet orange and lime aromas are coming out of this. And the head is just really finely bubbled and thick. This is looking and smelling like it's going to be a really good beer. Oh, and there's just this really interesting, slight malty toast thing happening in there that I don't know if that's influenced by some earthiness from the hops, too. Yeah, just a very, very slight toasted cracker almost, and I'm noticing. A lot more peppery and spicy in the flavor. And then I'm noticing that maltiness a lot. Yeah, it's almost like a graham cracker malt flavor is what I'm getting a lot out of this, which I don't know if I've noticed that from the other single cut beers. And this is 7.2% alcohol, which is like the same as their other regular IPAs, like the Moshuga Soulbender, which I liked a lot, or Moshuggy Soulbender, but that one was like only Southern Hemisphere hops. It's pretty good, but I think maybe I like the aroma a little bit more. I'm getting a lot of that, a lot of really kind of bitter, cross between bitter and sweet orange flavor mixed with that graham crackery malt, and definitely the lime is still happening. And, of course, not The bitterness is nowhere near what someone might think 122 IBUs is. Like, this is not really that bitter at all for me. After a few sips, it'll probably build up, but it's very drinkable. Well, there's something that's a little too savory. I wouldn't quite call this super juicy. And I'm noticing a little bit of the alcohol heat in the back of my throat there. Yeah, but it turns into something that's like, it's really toasty and earthy. Almost a slight pine, it's kind of woody in the bitterness, rather than any onion, garlic, sort of catty qualities. And I think that's probably coming from the Kohatu a little bit. The Kohatu's not intense, resinous, fresh green hops. That's not what's going on with that one I read. And it kind of makes sense. But it's, I kind of miss that. It's kind of got a big musky, woody sort of flavor. And with the graham crackery malt, it isn't my favorite. It's nice though. It's a good IPA. But maybe it's just not exactly my favorite hop combo. It's really cool because at Single Cut, they seem to really, their IPAs vary a lot, even though it's like all their regular IPAs seem to be 7.2% alcohol. And then a lot of them look very similar, but they do vary quite a bit depending on which hop varieties they use. My favorite ones from them is probably, of course, Softly Spoken Magic Spells, which I only had that on tap. And then their like Session IPA, the Billy 18 Watt. That one was that's probably my favorite beer from them. I've had that on tap and only one time in the bottle because I see it on tap around the Boston area way more. And that one is really, really great. With this, and now the bitterness is building up a little bit, and it's woody, it's kind of, it's resinous, but not in a necessarily green, piney way, or dank manner. It's very woody, as I said before. Yeah, I think I definitely like the aroma more. The flavor is just like graham cracker wood with some lime squeezed on top of it. I'm not getting much tropical fruit in the flavor, honestly. My cat's doing something weird over here. I think he's trying to burrow. That's what he likes to do in sheets. That's pretty funny, actually. Maybe I'll end this review and take a film of my cat then. So I'll give this like an 80. Maybe just like an 80. I'm not crazy for it. Maybe 78 even, because that bitterness and the flavor is just almost all earthy. And it's not super pleasant, honestly. So we'll do how about 79 for Is This the Real Life? Herb Single Cut.